Today we are going to create a gamer AI, but we don't want to go through the process of actually creating and texturing AIs. So that's why we are going to use a shortcut. For that, we will use Blender Kit. So in Models section, just search for Eye or Eyes. There may be a few ones, for example this one. This is great for Blender, but it's way too procedural and doesn't have the right texture size as well. What we will need today is this one, Real Blue Eye. This deposes what we can actually use in Unreal. First, we are going to quickly inspect this to see what we are dealing with. So this particular eye asset has four components, but the main ones we need are cornea, eye body, and iris. Select the iris. Under the data tab, you will find these shape keys. We need the vessels to be zero. In order to keep that, we are going to delete the shape key now. In order to keep the pupil size like this, we need to delete the base first. And now we can get rid of the iris shape key as well. We can delete the vertex group as well. Under modifier, we can apply these. Select the eye body, apply the modifiers, delete the vertex group. Same for cornea. Select these three objects, go object, parent, clear, and keep transform. Now we can delete these two. And if you want to see the mesh, just go here and select display in viewport. Now you can toggle it on and off. Now you right click and delete these. You can delete their collection as well. Now I'm going to delete my old eyes and just place the new one. Now, let's deal with the materials now. In the iris, we will have two materials. The eye body and the cornea will share the same material. You can delete this. It's basically a simple glass material. With the cornea selected, name the material cornea. Type the eye body and press this icon. Now we have created a duplicate of this material. Name the material scala. Name the object as well, like so. Now in the iris, we can get rid of this, the bottom one. Name the remaining material to iris. Let's check the scale, they are not right, so let's just apply all transforms for all three objects. Now, we will need to join these three into one mesh, but if you do it right now, we will get a weird result. So right away, we see some thematic possession. The reason this is happening is because the UV maps. So under iris, you can see that it has... Let me just undo this. So under iris, you can see that it has two UV maps. And this is not matching with the other two. So to fix that, copy the name UV map and then delete it with a minus. Then rename the convert map to UV map. And now if we join them, everything is alright. Scale is right, but just in case, apply all transforms. Going to mirror this right now, apply it, going to edit mode, wireframe, box select one of the eye, and with P I'm going to separate selection, name them accordingly, and now let's save down the iris texture. You can do this by clicking this unpack icon or just manually dragging a UV window and save it where you want it. Now we can close it and parent it to the rig. We only need the head bone. For quick optimization, we can delete the unnecessary vertex groups. Okay, now let's just export it. Create a normal map as well for our iris on this website. We only need the normal. Select just that and hit download. There is this site where you can change the color of the iris. Just drag and drop this image. You can easily select the iris. And now you can pick the color of your liking. However, this annoying register stuff will pop up. So you will have to register if you want to use it properly. I use Photoshop, but I looked up a free solution for you guys if needed. Now in Unreal we imported our character. And let's just import the normal and the different color iris that I just created. Start opening the materials. Let's just place our character in the scene. In the iris, just drag and drop the normal and the different iris color if you created one. Plug the normal into the normal, base color to the base color. And now that's it for the iris. Next, sclera. Change the color to a grayish color. Hold 1 and left click to create a parameter. set the main material to translucent and select surface translucency volume. Connect the parameter to the opacity and set it to 0.3. Add another parameter and set it to 0.8 and connect it to the specular. Now let's see the cornea. Again, select some grayish color. Select the material, set the blend mode to translucent. Light mode to surface forward shading. Bind refraction and select index of refraction. Now we have refraction in our material. Now create a bunch of parameters. We need one for metallic, for specular, for roughness and opacity. Let's convert all of them into a parameter. Right click, convert parameter, and name it accordingly. Now let's add a Fresnel node. Now look for a Lerp node. Connect it like so and plug it into the refraction value. Set the opacity to 0.3, the roughness to 0.1, the specular to 0.66, the metal to 1. Convert these two parameters as well. You can just name it like I am here. Now convert these values to parameter as well. Right click on the value and promote to variable. You can use the original values, but we will change it in a second. Now right click on the cornea material and create a material instance. Open your character, change the cornea material slot to our new material instance. Open the material and change these values accordingly. You can tweak them as much as you like, but I think this works well. In our sclera, we can set the metallic to 1 and the roughness to 0.1. And now if we take a look at it, it should be all good. However, it's far from perfect. It's an easy and quick way to get your character game-ready eyes, literally under a few minutes.